हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू माय चैनल एक्सीलेंट कोचिंग। लेट्स टॉक अबाउट साइकोलॉजिकल टेस्टिंग टुडे। सो वेन एवर वी वॉन्ट टू असेस द इंडिविजुअल डिफरेंसेस, वी यूज साइकोलॉजिकल टेस्ट। एंड दीज टेस्ट आर ऑफ वेरियस टाइप्स, लाइक वी हैव इंटेलिजेंस टेस्ट, वी हैव एप्टीट्यूड टेस्ट, वी हैव इंटरेस्ट टेस्ट, पर्सनैलिटी टेस्ट। सो वी यूज दीज टाइप ऑफ टेस्ट टू असेस डिफरेंट कैपेबिलिटीज एंड डिफरेंट capacities of individuals and how they are different in their intelligences, in their aptitude, in their interest and their personalities. These tests are used for various purposes. You can see whenever you go for some interviews and any employment interview in any company, you can see they use certain kinds of written test. Those personal selection tests are also a type of psychological test where they are trying to assess whether you are appropriate for the required job profile. Similarly, they are also used for placements, they are used for trainings also, and for diagnosis of certain disorders. These tests are administered in different contexts. They are administered in organizations, in educational institutions, defense establishment, guidance clinics. So you will see various places where these type of tests are available and they are being administered on people to find out what are the individual differences between them. A psychological test needs to be very objective and a standardized measure to assess people. Now, what do we mean by objective or objectivity? Whenever we are talking about any psychological test, there are 3 to 4 things that needs to be established. One is whether the test is objective. Second is whether it is reliable or not. Third is the validity of the test. And fourth is the norms that are being followed during the administration of the test. So what are these terms? Let us understand one by one. So here you can see the description of objectivity says, if two or more researchers administer a test on the same person, both of them would come up with the same result. That means if a test is objective, anyone who administers that test on the same person, the results will be almost same. The result will not vary more than an extent. So that is called objectivity. Suppose I am assessing one of my student and I left the school and another teacher came in place of me and she is also assessing the same student. The result of my assessment must be very similar to the result of another teacher's assessment. That will show that the test which we use to assess that child is objective and it is not subjective interpretation of the child. So if I am giving more marks to the child than the other teacher, that will show the subjectivity. But if both the scores of both the teachers are very correlated or very similar, that shows we have been very objective while administering the test, or the test that is used for assessing the child is very objective. That is called objectivity. Second thing is reliability. What is reliability? Consistency of scores obtained by an individual on the same test on two different occasions. Suppose you are administering a test on the same person with a gap of few days, few hours, or maybe few years. But if your test is reliable, the scores which is obtained by that individual must also be similar. It may not be very much same, it may have some amount of difference, but it should not be very different. Like suppose you are taking a personality test of a person who is very shy. You have assessed that person when he was an adolescent. After a few years, when he becomes a young adult, then again you go to that person and try to assess his personality. The child who has grown up as an adult may become more mature, may become more exposed to certain things and may start talking better than before. But द शाइनेस द नेचर ऑफ शाइनेस शुड रिमेन कंसिस्टेंट सो योर स्कोर्स विल बी ऑल्सो बी सिमिलर टू वट यू हैड स्कोर्ड टेकन दिस कोर्स प्रीवियसली सो देर शुड नॉट बी टू मच डिफरेंस इन द स्कोर्स ऑब्टेंड अर्लियर एंड ऑब्टेंड लेटर दैट इज कॉल्ड रिलायबिलिटी दैट योर टेस्ट इज गिविंग यू द सिमिलर स्कोर्स एवरी टाइम यू आर टेस्टिंग द सेम पर्सन ऑन इवन डिफरेंट ओकेजन्स. Next comes validity. Validity simply means the test is made to measure what it claims to measure. Suppose you want to measure mathematical skills of a student, but you have also included certain English terms which are difficult to understand by the child. You have given him a word problems in maths. We also have word problems, right? So you have given him word problems, but the wordings used in those questions is very difficult to comprehend. That means your test is not particularly aiming at only mathematical skills. That test also wants to measure the vocabulary of the child, and that is not a valid test. Your test should only be focusing on the mathematical skills, not the other disciplines. The validity of a test can be only be said that the test is valid when the test is measuring what it claims. So if an intelligent test is made and it is also testing creativity, then we cannot say the test is valid. And lastly, we have norms. So norms comes from the word normal, and normal means average. So what is the average scores of the different individuals? When we assess a large number of people, there is an average score that we get. That average score is called a norm, and that norm is used to compare the performance of different individuals. So these are the four properties, or we can say characteristics, of a good psychological test. In the next video, we will do types of tests. Thanks for watching.